Can you take an older car like this, repair this damage, this collision damage in your driveway, and get another 100,000, 200,000 miles out of it? Absolutely. I'm going to show you the techniques I've used dozens of times to pull this out and make it drivable, legal, working headlights, completely functioning. It's easier than you think. It takes about an afternoon and really doesn't cost much at all. So thanks to the planned obsolescence books, the NADA and Blue Book, the insurance company, even when it's not your fault, tells you that your car's not worth it. You know, it's not worthy of repair, even though it runs and works flawlessly. This car right here actually was salvaged out about 10 years ago, and there they told me it wasn't worth it, and I put another 120,000, 140,000 miles on it since then, and I'm gonna put another couple hundred thousand miles on it after I do it again. So what are we looking at as far as damage? This is pretty typical. I've done dozens of these for friends and families where they've rear-ended somebody else. And generally you end up a little more center damage, which is easier. This one has a little bit more major because we hit actually on one corner. And what I've actually done is you have the under the fender, the frame actually follows almost like the fender. And we've creased right down here. There's a little bit of a leg, and that's just been bent in, so that needs to be pulled out. And we've creased a little bit of the radiator core support up in here, the hood, of course, but that's actually bent down. So I'm pushed in. Let's see if I can get you guys square. That front end is pushed in almost a foot and down, I think, about 4 inches. But we can pull that all up with the come along and a tree. Let me show you. So what tools do you need? There's only actually one bare minimum tool you need, and it is a come along hand winch. That's it. Do not get the cheapest one. You need one that handles at least 4,000 pounds. But there's other things that help. I recommend probably two chains, preferably ones with the larger hooks versus this hook is designed to go back over the chain. This hook is designed to slide through the chain. This hooks around body panels better. Some eye hooks help. A pair of vice grips, something else to grab on to panels that are hard to grab on helps. But really all you need is this. I have used an electric winch before. The hand winch is the way to go because you can get a feel of how much you're pulling. One other major thing you will need, I guess, is a tree. I've done it with light posts. Something stable, something that's not gonna move at all. And so we're gonna use this tree. This tree has saved a lot of cars for neighbors and friends and family. So it's back to work again. I do have the wheels chalked because I'm gonna be pulling it. In this scenario, I don't know if you guys can see, I'm pulling here, pulling here. I've assessed the damage. Now, if it was straight on, I hit somebody straight on, I would just pull directly straight on. This one hit just in this corner, so what it's done to the car is kind of got to recreate the accident. It's pushed this back, but in doing that, it's also gonna push it this way. So I'm gonna pull kind of at this angle, and it's pushed it down, so I'm gonna try to kind of pull a little bit higher on the tree. Not much, because you're just gonna be lifting the car. So pulling it out will also pull it up. But let's rig it up and I'll show you. So this piece right here is actually part of the car frame. And you can see it's almost, I mean, I can barely get my finger through there. So that needs to be pulled out. The fender will have to be replaced if I want it to be pretty, but I can pound it pretty dang straight. The hood can be straightened out. All the stuff can be straightened out and drivable, so I can jam another headlight in there. The bumper, unfortunately, is missing a bunch of pieces. A lot of times on car bumpers, I'm able to, especially these plastic ones, you're able just to remove it and you can just drill holes and just stitch it together. I usually get like baling wire, but you could use zip ties or something else, and you just stitch it back together. It's just cosmetic. Leave all the damaged parts on for this technique. Leave the hood on, leave this on, because if you just pull this fender off, all the mounts for it are kind of screwed up. But if you pull out on this junk fender and pull it out, your mounting spots are going to be aligned where they need to be. So just pull directly from this, pull directly from your hood, pull directly from your radiator core support. You know, this radiator did crack. Most of the time, it's kind of funny, the radiator punctures, but the AC condenser doesn't. That's been the case for virtually everyone I've ever done. And the same thing, AC works, radiator's been cracked. So leave the radiator in there so you can get your spacing. Pull it out with that junk radiator in there and then slide the new radiator in when you're done. So I just quickly pulled the airbox so I could see the frame cross member a little bit better now that I can get in there. And you can see that it's bent. This is actually supposed to be pretty dang straight. It does have a little kink right there. You can see how far it's pushed over. That's normal. This is a crumple zone. This is supposed to accordion up so it doesn't happen into the cab of the vehicle and hurt the occupant. This is nothing. No structural, like the strut tower and stuff like that hasn't been touched. It's all in front of it that's been touched. I'm going to change my approach a little bit because I thought that the front end was actually being pushed over more than it's not as much as I thought it's being pushed over. It's because that has accordioned. So I'm going to start pulling from the straight on instead of at that angle anymore. And I think I'm actually going to, because that's such a structural member, it's going to take a little bit more force than the come along. Well, I could do it with come along, but it gets kind of scary when you're putting that much tension on it. So I'm actually going to wrap a chain around this member, and we're actually going to back it up and whack it a couple times to straighten it out. We've actually pulled it back about an inch, so keep going. We're getting there. Now, we're never going to be able to get that perfectly straight with this method. I'm going to actually have to tap down and against this side right here to flatten that out, and it should flatten out nearly perfectly. You know, I should be able to get that within an eighth of an inch to a quarter inch of how long it was originally. I think now I'm going to put the come along and put tension on this beam and then hammer it. So tension, hammer it. The front of cars, all the cars made in the last like 20-30 years, this stuff is paper thin. Everything on the whole front end of a front wheel drive car is just the thinnest sheet metal ever. Other than just looking at the bumper, if you look at it, everything is 90% there, very straight. All right, let's pop in here. Before, I could barely fit a finger. Now I can fit a fist. So we've moved that out 2 inches, 2.5 inches. Okay, I was pulling on that and hammering it, and there was just too much force. So now I just put it's actually a C channel, but a 2x4 or something else would work. So that's pushing on the outside of the frame, and the chain's pulling on the inside of the chain. And you can see we are pretty much dead straight. It's going to bounce back a little bit. So while it's in this position, I'm actually hammering on my seams. it's not faring so well. This was the good side, and this is my mangled side. I think that's pushed down and out a little bit. Even though the frame back there is pretty straight, that's just pushed down and out a little bit. But you can see it's just two bolt holes on each side, and that essentially hold the bumper. So even if you needed a, you know, makeshift a metal bracket just to hold that bumper up an inch or so. But now I can start taking the hammer directly to this. Just grab a thick bar or something. Look. And you tweak it back where you want. One of the best sheet metal benders out there are adjustable wrenches. And you just, because you can put it on and it bends it pretty dang straight back. If you got any bent pieces, it does way better, and the metal is nearly flawless compared to if you just use like a pair of channel lock pliers or something. So just an adjustable wrench. This, I don't know, you're spending so much force actually clamping it, or this, and kind of put it on, clamp it down, and you can just move it effortlessly. So I thought I'd show you guys this, just kind of an example. So these are the front bumper mounting tabs, and they're sitting just a little bit low. So if you see right here, I have a crease, so that's pulling them down. So I'm going to use an air hammer because it'll show you the strike. So I'm putting tension on it. This could be done, you know, I'm doing it with a jack, but this could be done with the come along upwards to a tree or something. And now I'm going to, you know, hammer right on that seam, and it's going to release the tension, and this is going to raise up. So it's noisy, but I'm going to show you. So now I've bent everything back pretty dang close. So now I can start fitting new panels if that's the route I'm going. And I do have a new bumper for it. But I can pop in here and you see these screw holes right here. I'm gonna have to really turn you. They are about, I'm about half inch that way. I thought I'd actually be too far this way. So I might've pounded that in a little too much that way. So let's just take it off and we'll pound it. Pull it back this way a little bit more. Looks like my height is good. It's hard to tell because I've, you know, it's supposed to butt into the bottom of that fender right there, but I have this fender smashed down right now. So this can be one of your best friends, the tape measure. So you can measure offset points, like back here against the windshield. I have these hooks. These are anti-decapitation hooks. They make the hood accordion up, so they don't, it doesn't slide up the windshield and decapitate you. But measured at certain points, you know, 33 5/8. Was this side was untouched, so I should have 33 5/8, the exact same point over here if I did a good job, and I have exactly 33 5/8 in the middle of this little bolt. So this front end, even though it was pushed back, has now been pulled back exactly the same amount. And you know, this top braided cord support is replaceable on most, on a lot of cars, and I have replaced this before in some people's cars. A lot of times it's so thin I just pull it out. But on this particular car, it's all, this whole front's all welded together, so you can't just replace just this. But you know, you just pull it out, measure it. If you go to the wrecking yard, take a scrap piece of paper with you and take these measurements. Measure off the firewall to the radiator, to the hood latch, and do all these measurements and make sure that, you know, and then come back and then make yours exactly the same, or, you know, within a quarter of an inch, an eighth of an inch, and you'll be just fine. You know, you can measure crosswise this stuff to make sure your front end isn't shifted over one way or the other. If you measure off those hooks back and forth, you'll be good. Just measure, 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 and whack it with a hammer. A little more whacking. Touched up some of the bare steel with a little bit of just spray paint, purple spray paint. You see it's looking, can't really tell. You look down that cross member now, looks not too bad, looks pretty good. So now don't just discount some of your parts because they're plastic and they're broken. A lot of these parts, you know, if you collected all the pieces from the accident, you can plastic weld them back together. I have a whole video on how to plastic weld, but you know, I can plastic with this weld this back together. Some of the tabs, there's supposed to be a tab on every corner, are still in the vehicle, some are not. You know, you could just, back here, you could just drill a little hole and wire tie it and put the grill back in, no big deal. On people's cars, like here's the turn signal lens. If I collected all the parts, you know, I have reassembled these things. You know, the main housing right here where the light is virtually unaffected, but I have re-plastic welded brake lenses back together, turn signal lenses back together. You know, it doesn't actually take that long. Just don't discount that stuff as like completely garbage. Especially if you're trying to save a buck or two and do this job, you know, that could save you 25, 30, 40. It could save you $100 on some cars. Some homemade specialty tools you might have seen me use are nothing more than just scraps of metal that I've bent and have hooks in, and this I bolted on and pulled with it. This is just a unmodified pair of vice grips with a piece of metal and a hole and another little piece of metal that the hook can hook through. You saw me pull out the hood, but you know, things like that. But really the only necessary part is the come along. There we go, all back together. I did touch up some of the parts just with like Home Depot spray paint that was just close. Not perfect, but I did touch it up and I banged out the hood. I just wanted to show you guys what it would look like with minimal investment. The only thing that's really replaced is the headlight, the turn signal, and the bumper. That's about all that I replaced in this entire thing. But I mean, look at it. It doesn't glare at your eye. I actually think that I do have a new fender, a new hood, and stuff. I will replace them when I repaint it, but I think nothing looks worse than having a white fender on a car. I think a dented fender looks way better, because the white, it just looks like crap. Or a white hood on the car, it just, you know, driving around like that for a while. This, it'll drive around like this for a while, making sure everything's good. But there you go, that's it. My total cost for this, $60 in an afternoon, you know, probably a little bit longer, just because I played around with making these a little bit smoother and everything. But
straight threes, all are crossed.